What's up, guys? So we got a question from Anthony Morrow, who says he's wanting to learn how to catch a guillotine from guard. So that's his question. So Anthony, I'm going to show you how to set up a guillotine from guard and give you a couple options from there. As always, this is my lovely assistant, Mr. Adam Wilson. Let's get started. By the way, I know you hate this, guys. So check this out. Ready? Damn, I almost made it the whole mat. Next time. So Anthony, we're going to start from guard. So we're going to set this up first with a Kimura sweep type position. So when I come into it, maybe, you know, get the hands down, whatever, I'm gonna sit up here to where I can attack the Kimura, that kind of thing. Now, in some cases, if the person just lazily puts their head right here, then you're set up right into position, that's fine. But a lot of times people are mindful of that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start to create space, and the idea that I'm gonna use is I'm gonna create the space so that he puts his head where I want it. Meaning, if his head's like up really high, which will happen, if I try to go for the guillotine, it can be really difficult. But if his head's down low, okay, and maybe driving into me, it's a little bit easier. So what can I do to maybe make this happen? Well, if we're in this butterfly, or not butterfly, but Kimura sweep position, if I start to create some space here to get away from him, a lot of guys will instinctually just drive into me. As he drives into me, bam, we can start to set this up. Now, we'll get our connection, right? I've got my grip. When we finish our guillotine, it's very important that we don't fall back to our backs flat, but rather we get to the side here on an angle, right? And again, when we finish, it's rocking the baby, boom. By rocking the baby, I mean just doing this, okay? Now, if we're in this situation, let's say that we get down here and he's maybe, as I scoot back here, he's not putting his head down, he's not driving back into me. I can pop up, boom, into a front headlock position, okay? I'm gonna be easy on Adam right now for the video, but I could pop up into a front headlock position and immediately sit back into it for the, you know, arm in, arm out guillotine, and go right back for it. So let's look at those two options one more time. Again, in just sort of a quick sort of side parallel, maybe a little side tangent, is that this is kind of like the double leg versus a snap down from the front headlock. If I snap down from a front headlock and go for it, it's not to say that it doesn't work, because it does work, right? But again, as soon as I start going for this, the person's gonna be, you know, in high alert, because again, I pulled their head down. But if he was to shoot in for a double leg here, boom, he's putting his head in the position, and now I can drop back into it. So what we're trying to do is kind of get the same idea going. I'm trying to make space so the person puts their head there. So again, we get those hands posted, I sit up, and I'm going. I start to create space. As I feel him driving into me, I start to go, get my position. Again, touch to the side, rock the baby high elbow. If for some reason he's not driving into me, I can post on his back foot, almost like a technical stand-up, just kind of not necessarily stand up all the way, but just to come up to a front headlock position, boom, right in position. And then from here, I can drive back in and put the guillotine in. And again, with the guillotine, there's a ton of different variations. I can do the full locked guard position here. I can put in half guard here, okay? The big thing that I don't want to happen is I just don't want the person to get across my body. So step over to your right, Adam. Right here, that would be bad. Or even if he gets to a half guard, this would be bad. But as long as he's either center or towards the same side as the head that I'm hanging on to, I'm good, okay? So that would be a few little options that you could look for with your guillotine choke. So the idea again is to come up to your guard, you can attack with that Kimura position, begin to push away, make some space to get the person to come in, and if you can get them to come in and drive into you, a lot of times you can sink that arm right into position for that guillotine. If they don't take it, as you're making space, pop up. A lot of guys in jiu-jitsu don't do this. They don't like just pop up, but no one says that you have to sit there and stay on your butt. So if for some reason the person who's passing is not putting a lot of pressure on you, back up and pop up to your feet, and you can go right into a front headlock type position and set it up from there. So, brother, I hope that helps you. Hope it helps you with your guillotine chokes, and I'm finished. Adam?